No Notes.
Well, hello and good afternoon. Welcome to another great episode of No Notes Show. Today, we have a very special guest in our midst, and I'm very happy that we finally have been able to come together and get this wonderful lady on the show. How about that, Doc?
I'm in awe. I'm speechless.
Just speechless. We would like to introduce Miss Jeneen Barlow. And what we're going to do today is talk about her. She's going to share with us some career details, family, talk about her book, and some workshops that she's involved in, and give you some mentoring tips on how to be excellent, right? So let's get started. First, how are you today?
I am fantastic today. How are you?
I'm just fine. How you doing, Doc? Everything
good? I'm fine.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So first, Jeneen, please tell our audience a little bit about yourself.
Sure. I'm a native Philadelphian. I grew up in Mount Airy, Philadelphia.
Okay.
And I like to say right across the street from Cedarbrook Mall. And really, people really know that you were
identify with
then,
the
right?
Area. Right, exactly.
And so I went to Catholic school for 8 years. Then went on to creative and performing arts as a visual artist. Started dancing when I was in high school also. Went to Rider University in New Jersey. And then to Eastern for my master's work.
Okay.
And I met this amazing gentleman named Mr. OMAR Barlow.
Okay. Remember OMAR, right, everybody?
We have another term for him.
My prince.
There you go.
My prince.
Okay.
I'm striving for that.
Yes. My prince, OMAR Barlow.
Right.
And then I actually stopped working. I worked at Temple before
okay.
Eastern. And I was on my way to law school. I was going to Widener Law. My plan was all set for it.
Okay.
But I didn't want to travel as much as I needed to for my job. Met OMAR, learned about a master's of economic development, which was very much in line with my goals, even though it wasn't law school. And so I decided to pursue that path. Ended up teaching at the university and being a high-level administrator there, program directing, curriculum writing, loved it.
Wow.
And then we started our business in 2001. The same year we married, and
wow,
13
that was a full agenda, right?
13 years later, I have my prince, OMAR Barlow. I have Joshua, Grace, Nathaniel Barlow. There will be no additions unless we adopt sometime in the future.
That sounds like a famous last word.
Those are my famous last words. It's recorded now, so I have this to go back to.
Here's the proof, folks.
In case I need to pull this out. And so we've just been having a wonderful time over the past 13 years with business and family and living on purpose.
Okay. So tell us a little bit. We kind of just led into a little bit about your business. So please share with us a little bit of information about Barlow Enterprises and how it got started and some of the things that you engage in with the company.
Sure. We started out as a More Excellent Way Presenters. And so that was in 2001, and we spoke at national conferences. We spoke on leadership, relationships, all different kinds of things.
Okay.
With the vision of teaching other people our processes that we were developing to help people live, you know, with clarity, to know their mission statement, to know their vision statement, all these different, because we're educators, right, by training, we developed all of these different courses, and we were thinking we would have other presenters who were interested in teaching our material, learn it, and then teach in different venues.
Okay.
As we continued to grow in our careers, what happened was the services that we began to provide expanded to professional development and consulting. You know, we've built schools, we've done all these different things. And so we changed the name to stay in line with our vision. We changed it to Barlow Enterprises, but that became a more overarching umbrella for the consulting, for the I like to call myself a life strategist, but commonly known as life coaches.
Actually, I like the way that sounds a little better, life strategist.
Well, I think even not just how it sounds, but I'm not really coaching someone through life. What I'm doing is helping them. I'm coming alongside them to give them a process by which they can guide their lives and get clarity so that they can move from where they are to where they want to be. It's about providing them a strategy that they don't have for themselves at that particular time. And so I'm not really coaching, like cheering you on, but I'm really giving you strategy for moving from one point to the next. I always say, like with raising children, if I do a good job with my partners,
right,
then they won't need me anymore.
Right.
And they'll go on and do it their own. So Barlow Enterprises is a consulting, coaching. We write curriculum, and we speak. We speak at all different venues in all different venues across the nation.
Okay.
I know Doc has a question that leads right into this, so I'm going to pass it over to you, my friend.
Yes. I guess my question is, I'm still stuck on the fear factor and being an introvert. If that was my situation, I could come to you and you would attend your workshops, or how would I go about it?
Sure, that's a great question, Doc. I actually have a partner right now,
okay,
who came because he sees himself being a speaker,
okay,
but he wants more development on that.
Okay.
Brilliant gentleman. He's a PsyD in psychology, has his own practice, and he works around the city also.
Okay.
And so we would start out with a consultation, which I usually do gratis, a 30-minute consultation. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we'll get you signed up.
Okay.
And then I create an action plan for you, a customized action plan based on all the information that I gathered during our talk together.
Okay. Usually, so I would have to open up to you?
Yes, but
some
you would.
Innermost.
No, your innermost, okay, deepest secrets, no.
Those that I took to the grave. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
So we would decide, first, we always start with mission. So we founded the Destiny Statement Institute. And that institute has all the courses and all the things I talked to you about was in it. But one of our hallmarks is the Destiny Statement.
I was going to ask you about that.
Oftentimes, people don't have a mission statement for their lives. Statistics say that 97% of people do not have written down goals for their lives. And so a mission statement we do, a vision statement we help you do. That's usually we start with if people don't have it already.
Okay.
And the reason I'm mentioning that in the process of helping you get over the fear of speaking to answer your question is that your ability to speak well is almost always related to how sound and how firm and excited you are about your mission. What am I speaking for? To whom am I speaking? Why am I speaking? And so we talk around that, and then we get you strategy. I always say that confidence doesn't just come to us, but it comes from being competent.
See, that's what I was going.
Competence leads to confidence, but I need to know why I need to be competent. And so getting your passion and interest and clarity around why you're speaking. Why do I need to hear Doc's story, his voice, his plans for whatever it is he's telling me about? Once you get confident about that, and you get competent, and then the fear will start to go away. And I talk in the book, Don't Be Scared, BEspeak, about power, love, and sound mind, and that principle of power, love, and sound mind, and how that helps you couple all these things together to get over the fear.
Okay. So I'm just sitting here just thinking about taking in what you just said. So you're telling people to take a look and, so to speak, in the mirror and pull out, you know, look for what's your passion.
Yes.
And pull that out.
Absolutely.
From within them so they can see it.
Absolutely. But this is also the starting point, right? And so the proverb that we base our teaching about mission on for the Destiny Statement process is a proverb that says, purpose in the heart of a man is like deep water. Mm-hmm. But a man or woman of understanding will draw it out. Purpose in the heart of a man is like deep water. But a man or woman of understanding will draw it out. And so it's my job, as I walk alongside you, to draw that out. That's why I'm listening intently in our sessions, and that's why I'm taking copious notes. And then I sit in my quiet space and develop a custom action plan for you based on what I've heard.
Okay, suppose an individual has some sort of a speech impediment,
mm-hmm.
or perhaps not so much a speech impediment, but Well, let's say he had a speech impediment, and in his developmental years, maybe his parents might have been a little rough, and so they may have, when they experienced that condition, maybe they would shout at them or scold them or
yes.
punish them.
Yes.
That makes them revert back into this deep shell. How would you reach someone like that? First of all, how would you gain their confidence, for lack of a better word, to share that with you?
Yes. Well, we start to talk about why you're afraid.
Okay.
But let's go back again, never leaving the mission and the vision behind.
Okay.
Because everything for us is connected to that. And so in spite of what your parents may have done or said, and that can be traumatic, it can
true,
come up every
true,
time you
true,
get ready to speak,
true.
You hear those voices in your head,
right?
Telling you that what you say isn't going to be good enough, or you sound funny, or whatever that is.
Exactly.
But we can get over that when we understand your mission, because you're living on purpose, and your mission and vision, it's never really just about you. And so my conversation to you would be, your story is so powerful.
Mm-hmm.
How many young people who went through what you went through, who felt what you felt, how many of them could you help by sharing this?
True,
and
yes.
isn't that more important?
It's so true, yes.
Than
yes.
you being afraid to get up there?
Okay.
And so I start to talk about the why and how it's bigger than we are, and that helps move us beyond the fear.
Oh, okay.
Man, that is an awesome concept. I mean, when you think about it,
well, see that goes.
I'm ready.
Well, see that goes back to what we were talking about earlier. That they have a quote where they say, "Great speakers are not born; they're taught."
That's true. That's true.
So, I was just wondering, was that just rhetoric, or you know?
Right. Right.
I'm impressed. I'm really impressed.
So let's. I mean, we're leading right into the book now. So before we get started. A little more detail about the book. We have the book right here, so I'm gonna hold it up closer to the camera so
okay.
everybody can get a good look at it.
It's my study copy, so excuse all the notes and.
So you got highlighted, and I see you got markers.
Here's a picture or an image of what the book looks like. Again, this is a study copy, so your copy wouldn't look this way, but just to give you an idea of what we're talking about. Okay, so now I'm gonna put that down for a second. And so now, tell us about, just give us an overview of the book.
Sure. Don't be scared, BEspeak, how to prepare, present, and inspire your audience to action is the name of the book. And what I really intend for it to be is a workbook, a playbook that you can just grab, look through if you have to go speak somewhere. You can get a few key things that will help you make that presentation more excellent, will help you move those people into the action that you desire for them to take. And so what happened, how the book was born, people just kept asking me through another business that I'm building,
okay.
how do you speak in a way that gets people to just move to action like that? And they would ask me, can you help me? And I would just say, yes, I can help you. And then I thought, you know, Doc, I need to write something that can help everybody all at
exactly,
once, you
exactly.
know? And so
one size fits all.
Yeah. And what Omar and I have been doing for over 13 years, I said, you know what? Let me really think about this and document it in a way that would be of service.
Okay. I have a question. Does that go? You have three characteristics: reflect, experience, and what was the preparation?
Preparation.
When you address an audience.
Preparation.
Or group.
Preparation. Reflection.
Reflection.
The reflection and preparation. This is. Well, I talk about that when I talk about the key things that people do that usually stop them from doing an effective.
Okay.
A lot of times we fail to reflect, we don't prepare well enough, and we procrastinate.
That's not familiar.
And you mean in terms of self-reflection?
Self-reflection and or thinking about what do I want and need to happen. I like to think about first for the people. So I view speaking before people and just even sitting here with you all, whether it's one person or whether it's thousands,
okay.
I view it as a privilege. And so I don't enter into it lightly. I have to go and deliver something to those people in that time.
Right.
And so I need to reflect, and I need to be very conscious of what they need to receive from me in that space and time.
Okay.
So I'm reflecting on what is it that the people need. That's most important to me. And then what do I need from them? And this is something I talk about in the book because I didn't think about that all the time. For many years as a speaker, we would just give and give and give and give, but we never thought about what we needed to do to grow our business.
Okay.
Right? And so what do I need from them? Do I want the people to get the book at the end of this presentation? Or do I want them to talk with me about consulting services? Or you need to, as a professional, not just go in with all heart. That's most important, I think. Because if you don't have heart and you don't care about the people, what they buy, that's going to be fleeting.
Okay.
Eventually, people will say, she didn't care about me. But you do need them to purchase your services if you're going to keep doing what you do. And so that's my message to business people. Because I know so many business people who are so passionate and care so much about their people that they're not building a sustainable business because they haven't learned the strategies necessary in order to push their business forward. So that's the reflecting, the two pieces of reflecting. And then don't procrastinate. It's on your calendar. What do you need to do to be prepared? Because when you're prepared, you're not going to be as afraid.
Okay.
And you know what people do, and probably all the, I won't say everybody, but for the most part, most people, you know, they, in terms of procrastinating, they do that. They'll sit down, they'll have it written. They're like, okay, this is what I'm planning. A, B, C, I got it planned. And then when it gets closer and closer time, oh, okay, well, I'm going to do this over here first. I'm going to put this on. I mean, before you know it, you look up and time is just gone.
Yes.
Okay. You know, so, I mean, I can relate exactly to what you
sure.
mean. Don't hold back. Don't wait. Seize the moment. That's part of how No Notes got started. I mean, because just a little, I mean, not to go in too much into that, but I mean, we were just sitting around having conversations, multiple conversations about different topics. And immediately, another partner that's not here, he lives in New York, that handles operations in New York for us. He mentioned it, and brother mentioned it. He said, you know what, we're sitting here talking about all these things. We need to start sharing it with the world, take action. Mm-hmm. But we didn't hold back. I mean, so that's, again, that's very important, not to wait, not to hold back. Get your agenda set and then go for it. I mean, because it's out there. I mean, you could do it. You could definitely do it. Is that right, Doc?
Yeah, that's very true. But what I was just thinking about, I keep going back to what you were saying about that we're not destined to be fearful. And you said, but to be... with his love and clarity of mind.
Power, love,
and power. Could you kind of elaborate on that a little bit?
Definitely. I tell a story in the book that my three young children, since they were little, you know, eventually all children come to that spot when they are afraid to sleep or had a bad dream or I'm scared to go to school for some reason or whatever it is. And so we've always taught them that you have not been given a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and soundness of mind.
Okay.
So any one of my little ones, 7, 9, and 11, they say they're scared. I say, does that have a place in your mind, in your heart, in your life? And they'll say no. And I'll say why. They said, because I have power, love, and a sound mind.
Okay.
And so I talk about taking the time, again, this goes with the preparation, to get into a quiet space of reflection and really say these things to you. I have power. I have love, I have soundness of mind. However you decide to say it, you know, and get that into your psyche, into your being, and it will permeate through you. The energy that you give off will show that you are powerful, that you're full of love, and that you have a sound or clear mind.
I have one more question before we move on to our next question. Do you consider yourself a resonant leader in terms of, you know, what you stand for? What matters most to you, what you value most, and what you're passing off to others to get them to rise up to the next level?
Yes. I believe that I'm a leader. I think I've always been a leader in many ways since I was a young child, and I see myself not only as a leader in general, but as a leader among leaders.
Powerful. Powerful. Let me just sit back for a minute on that one.
Wow.
So now, let's talk about family a little bit, because we're just leading into the next question very easily, and which is great. Now, with all that you do, you have a business, you're running a company, you're doing workshops, you're promoting your book. Where does family fit into all that?
Well, it's all in synergy, and that's why it works. When I say that it's all in synergy, what I mean is back to my mission, right?
Okay.
My mission is to inspire, educate, and equip people to live lives of excellence. And so I have an order in which I live my life, and it helps me to make decisions. You know, when you feel overwhelmed, or you feel like, should I do this or that, and you're just not sure, I go back to my core philosophy. And that's why that needs to be in place. Mm-hmm. Because as we work, things happen, a lot's coming at us. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you got to draw back and say, okay, what am I supposed to be doing?
Right.
And so here's my order. God, me, my health, my wellness, my professional and personal development, my prince, Omar Barlow, my children, Joshua, Grace, and Nathaniel, and then my business. And some people would say, well, if this business is all the way over here in five, then how does that work? Well, it works because I determine that if the God piece is in order, then that will flow, and I'm in order, then that is what flows into or empowers all the other areas. And in our society, there's a couple issues with my order. Right? I'm a sociologist by training. I took sociology and business courses on a university level. And so I know that sociologically and just in our culture in general, there are a couple issues.
Might be an issue with that,
right?
Okay.
Even within a certain faith realms, there's a big issue with my order. Number one, God. Most people don't have a problem with God being first. For most people, that's not an issue.
Right.
But for me to be second is an issue for some people, and not my husband second, or my children second, or my children before my husband, right?
Okay.
But if I am not well, if I am not whole, then my question is, how can I give them anything that's more excellent?
Exactly.
So I'm going to be okay with you crying if I need to go jog for a few miles, or saying, don't eat that because that's there for me. You know, I grew up with a mom who was incredible. I mean, my mom, Sandra Winters, was one of the most phenomenal people you'll ever meet.
Okay.
She was so selfless.
Really? Okay.
Sometimes to a fault.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And so what she was teaching me in her latter years was not to be that way.
Okay.
But what was interesting was that I didn't get the lesson. Kept doing
right?
what I saw her do because it was ingrained.
Right, exactly, exactly.
And she kept saying, "Don't do that, Lenny. Don't do that."
Okay.
And I kept saying, "Well, why is she telling me that? You know, this I'm doing what she did, and she's amazing. So this has to work out."
Yeah.
But when she passed on, I got it.
Okay.
I got
it. She was trying to break that cycle.
She, because that wasn't the right order.
Okay.
Because if I'm broken down, then I can't give out
true.
Anything of quality
That's
to anyone
true.
Else.
That's
so and
true.
So I've trained my family to understand that, and I'm teaching Grace to do that. Being a 9-year-old, I was trying to get it much later. My mom was teaching me that lesson. And I teach my boys that also. And so then my husband, why? Because if I do a good job, Doc, those children are going to leave us.
Okay.
And I need to look at Omar Barlow
true.
And still
so
love
true.
And adore
That's
him.
So true.
Yes?
That
and so
true.
My kids know. Nathaniel, my 7-year-old, adores me.
Okay.
He told my husband, Daddy, you need to get your own wife.
Wow.
Oh.
And so he told me the other day, he said, my birthday was on Sunday.
Okay.
And he said, Mommy, why does Daddy make you go on all these dates?
Make you.
And I said, that's interesting.
Interesting
he
term.
He doesn't make me. I love going on
right.
dates with Daddy. And he said, oh, okay. He's always hugging on you and kissing on you. But
well, that sounds a little possessive.
Yeah, his is like, you need to check in with me.
Right.
Let me know what's going on,
that's right?
right.
But this is amazing. amazing for them because when they see that we're connected, it makes them feel
right.
more secure
right.
than if we put every single bit of our attention into them.
Right.
Okay. And see, that's where those important family values come on, because as they see it now, when they become adults, that's how they're going to be with whoever their significant other is. So it starts, it definitely, the teaching definitely starts in the home and how you develop and build and pick up those important values.
Definitely.
But what's intriguing also is the fact that she's not just verbally teaching them.
Yeah.
You know, she's giving them a role model.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. And I love the visual. I think it's
exactly.
I mean, it's good,
it reinforces the
read. And good to talk and speak, but the actual get a visual count of things too is very helpful as well.
They laugh and they enjoy, you know, watching us love each other because it makes them feel secure. And yes, it gives them a vision for what they should expect.
Strong family, right?
Exactly.
That's right.
Nothing
that's
less.
That's right.
At least that or more
right.
is what their expectations should be.
Right.
And then, you know, my business.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, my children and my business. My children. You know what they take. You know they
yes.
take everything. But
yes.
I want to give that because the time has already been up so fast.
Right.
You know, and
right.
so and then it's my business. And when things mess with that order, then I have to reevaluate whether
sure.
I'm doing what I should be.
So that's the key. The key is having order, and you can accomplish so much in various
yes.
areas. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, just speaking of the order, I mean, first let me say I don't see an issue with it. I think it's very well sound. But it, I mean, I was just thinking about what God says in the Bible, just to reference that. I mean, in terms of how the marriage, if you're married, how that looks, God first, then your union, then your children.
Yes.
Okay.
So even from the biblical sense, I mean, that's how things should be. And I can absolutely relate. I mean, because if you don't have your health, you don't have anything. You can't do anything.
Right.
If you're not healthy, you're not going to be able to work. You're not going to be able to take care of your husband or your wife
right.
or your children. You're just not. You're not going to have any that the energy or the purpose that you need. So I see that.
Yes.
I understand that.
Yes,
well,
definitely. A
what do you think? What do you think, Dottie? You got
yeah,
anything?
Yeah, I'm sitting here, and I don't want to get into a gender thing. But I just want to say that what we're talking about is very powerful, and the fact you're talking about order and what your order look like, I find too often, from a female perspective, they tend to share too much with friends and female. It's almost like they build their friendship off of their relationship by going to each other saying, he said this, he did that, whatever, almost saying, what should I do?
Mm-hmm.
Or, and then she goes back to him, as opposed to going to him and find out what his inner thoughts are or problems or whatever. That's where the source of the problem is him, not her. She can't communicate to you what a man is dealing with or what his priorities are, whether you agree with him or not. And that's why I just think that, you know, it should be more direct to your other, significant other, and find out what is your problem, what's going on, whatever. And that goes both ways.
Yes.
Yeah, that goes both ways.
Yeah.
Yes.
Any thoughts on that?
Well, the gender, absolutely. I mean, you can only clear up any communication issues by speaking to the person
right.
with whom you have a child, right?
Right?
Women are more relational, some women. That's never been my practice, but I do see that with a lot of females,
right.
because we relate in different ways, and so
true, that's
you
true.
Have to,
that's true.
But you do need to be conscious and careful. I look at it as protecting your significant other. So certain things you just don't, the way I was brought up,
okay.
you just don't discuss
right.
with anybody other than that person. And
exactly.
if you need to talk about
I mean, if there's
it,
an issue, that's
right.
the person
if it's
you need
something
to talk
where
to.
You're, unless it's something where there is like abuse or something
okay.
like that.
Oh,
you're
yeah,
not,
yeah.
You're
oh,
not,
yeah, you're right, right.
You're
right,
not
right.
talking
okay,
about
right.
that.
No, right.
But I just mean things that need to be worked out with couples. Then, yes, you need to go to that person. And what I was going to say also in terms of gender is that it's just the selflessness that I talked about. I talked to so many women. I have so many friends. And I was that mom. I was that wife who was just like, I'll do something for me later. I'll do something for me later.
Oh, yeah,
you know,
yeah,
the
yeah.
kids need this.
Yeah.
My husband needs this. The house needs this.
Right.
And I was overweight. I was exhausted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I wasn't taking care of myself.
Right.
the way I needed. My mind was clouded, you know. I was still getting a lot done, but I didn't feel or look my best.
As energized, right?
Because that wasn't my focus.
Right.
And so just making that small shift. And then what happens? You know, now my children say, well, Mom, can I run that 5K with you? Or, you know, Josh told me yesterday, that's my 11-year-old, Mom, I ran half a mile today. I did really well. Or, oh, guys, you better not eat that. Mommy's not going to be happy about that. You know, what would Mommy say? And my little children, 7, 9, and 11, talk about protein and carbs and macronutrients
because they see me living it.
And so if I hadn't made that shift, then they wouldn't be beneficiaries of that information
or that example either. So true. That's so true.
Great, great. So now, you have so much to offer, Jeneen. I mean, we talked about several things here. Tell us what resources are available to access you, to get to you, to talk to you, to attend a workshop. What are the resources that you use to get the word out?
Absolutely. Well, in this big world of social media, I am on every single social media platform.
Okay.
So I'm very big on Facebook. And I strongly recommend anyone who wants to get in touch with us for services, visit Barlow Enterprises on Facebook and just like the page and you'll see all the posts about the next up and coming events and coaching programs and all of that. And then there's Twitter. We're on Twitter as Be More Excellent. We're on LinkedIn. We are on Instagram. And so you can find us, whatever your favorite social media site is, you can find Be More Excellent.
We're going
to
be there.
We're there.
Okay.
We are there. And then we do fantastic webinars through the Destiny Statement Institute.
Okay.
So you can learn about those also on our Facebook page.
Okay.
And many of them are free. And so many of them are sessions like my group coaching that we do every last two Fridays of the month. I only take 35 people because I want to give people quality time
Answers.
So I'm not looking for a big crowd.
Okay.
But we only take 35 people per month. And I'm doing a fall special right now. It's only $47. It's usually $198. Five courses.
Okay.
But this is what I love. When you leave group coaching, you have a mission statement written for your life.
Mm-hmm.
You've learned about, I love doing this. It's so much fun. We've done thousands by now over the 13 years for schools and companies and individuals. But every single person leaves that coaching with a mission statement for their life.
Okay.
They're like fingerprints, Doc. Nobody leaves with anyone that's the same. It's their guiding statement. And then we teach, Omar and I both teach in group coaching. So you get Live on Mission, you get the four pillars of purpose.
Mm-hmm.
We've designed a course around what we have found are four pillars that everyone needs to build their life upon.
Okay.
And we get that teaching. And then we do Creating Your Vision and Destiny. We do a whole teaching on that. We then teach on the seven key areas of life also. And so it's just packed with information. The webinars are exciting. And the group coaching is fun. You get to network with other people too.
Okay.
Excellent, excellent. So
very powerful.
Along with that, I just want to hold up the book one more time. Again, you would get, when you purchase this, is a fresh copy, a new copy. just to reiterate, right? But tell us,
it's available on Amazon.
How can we? Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
The book is available on Amazon. It's also available at www.bemoreexcellent.com. That's our website.
Okay.
And so if you're not a social media person, which some people aren't, you can get on to www.bemoreexcellent.com, click on the resources, and you can order the book right from the website. Or if you're an Amazon person, just type in my name, Jeneen Barlow, and you can order a book from Amazon.
And who's not an Amazon person? Let me jump on that because I know I am.
Yes.
I love Amazon. So, I mean, if you're not, even if you didn't want to go, just like you said, to social media or the rest of it, go right to Amazon because we know how many people shop on Amazon. Probably everybody, right?
Yeah.
So, before we get ready to close out, your slogan to me is just powerful. Be excellent. Tell us a little, just about that. Give us a little bit on that.
I'm so glad you asked me that. A lot of people don't ask, and I love to share why. And so the whole motto is work, love, live, be more excellent. And the reason it's in that order is very, very intentional. So Omar and I believe that our philosophy comes from Genesis,
okay,
right? So God gave the man first work.
Okay.
The woman was inside of him, so we believe that he also gave her work.
Okay.
And then he brought her out of him, and there was this union. There okay. was love. And then they went work, love, to live, and what the scripture tells them was to take dominion.
Take
dominion.
Dominion. Okay.
Over the
dominion.
Earth.
Okay.
And so working, we believe that a lot of people are unhappy in their love lives because they have been unclear about what their life's work is.
So true.
And so if I don't know what my life's work is, how do I know how to choose or who to choose or who to say yes to or who to say no to?
Right.
Right? And so when Omar and I came together, I saw that I could grow into him.
Mm-hmm.
But that was because I had thought about where I wanted to be in my future.
Okay.
And some people are doing what I say, which is something we should never do as men or women, which is marrying people's potential.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not interested in marrying who you're going to become or what I see you could, you know,
right.
get into that.
Right.
But I need to see something solid. I need to be clear about where you're going, and then I need to decide whether that is in synergy with where I am going,
mm-hmm.
and whether you are going to be able to handle who I'm becoming.
Okay.
Mm. So Omar, he promotes my book more than I do.
Okay.
He's more excited. So then I'm thinking about what the next thing to write, but he's excited. He's proud. I don't have an issue because we are one.
Okay. In the true sense of the word.
In one. In the
okay.
true sense of the word. We call each other our other self. He is my other self. I am his other self.
Okay.
And so that's because we were clear about our life's work individually mm-hmm. before we came together.
Okay.
Work. Then there's the love.
Okay.
And then there's the living, and living in a way that through your work and your love, you take dominion over any area that you go into. So whether it's the school, whether it's I'm on stage somewhere, whether it's through the internet teaching courses, I go with the mind that I'm taking dominion over this area because I have something to give to people
okay.
right here and now. And then all of that together leads to us being our more excellent selves.
Wow, that's powerful.
That's potent.
You know, this might be a little off base, but this just makes me think about my younger days a little bit and how my aunt, his wife, she would tell my brother and I, you know, you need it's very important for you to associate yourselves with individuals that are about something, that are about or are about some of the similar things that you're trying to be about.
That's right. To help
and what you do, you come together, you get together, you make friends that way, and then everybody helps to build each other.
Exactly.
I just immediately went back to that thought.
Exactly.
I mean, and that stayed with me
yeah.
all these years. I mean, you know, at first it's not to get into a whole nother subject, but you know, when you're coming up, I know I was a knucklehead,
I'll never tell.
But you know, in those moments, what is she talking about? That's what you kind of think.
Sure.
But now I appreciate that. I mean, because eventually, which I'm one of the things that I'm so proud of, I was able to look and reflect, like
yeah.
we said earlier, and start to evolve, start to turn some things around in my life.
Yeah.
And as you can see, you know, today
yeah.
this is where we are, and we're still growing.
Yeah.
So, but that's so true. I mean, you know. What you just said. And so I just thought about that little bit of story just to relate. But before we go, could you just tell us one more time how we could reach you, how people can reach you, our audience can reach you to get involved, take a workshop, you know, learn how to be excellent and where to get the book and the next two workshops that you have coming up.
Definitely. So you can visit me on www.bemoreexcellent.com. You can also visit us on Facebook by liking Barlow Enterprises mm-hmm. on Facebook. And we're on Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram. I'm not on Pinterest yet, but okay. I'll see if I can get it. And so we work to really be present on all of these. You can definitely get the book, Don't Be Scared, BEspeak, How to Prepare, Present, and Inspire Your Audience to Action from Amazon.com, or again from Barlow Enterprises website, www.bemoreexcellent.com. Some people may just want to send me an email. You can send that to info@bemoreexcellent.com. All the words are spelled out completely. And what we're doing next, definitely join us for group coaching. It's the last two Fridays of October, November, or December, the last two Fridays. And what you'll get is five courses of amazing information taught by my husband, Omar, and I. But what I'm most excited about is that your walk away, you have a lot of walkaways from the group coaching, but your walk away is that you will leave those sessions with a personal mission statement for your life.
Excellent. And along, just to add to that, the information that Jeneen just gave you, we will also be sharing her information, Omar's information, as we have done in the past, on our venues, on our pages. So you know where we are. Same thing, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. We have our own website, which I'll announce at the very end before we close out. But plenty of resources to find Jeneen and get in contact with her. We absolutely say this is a must. Don't miss out. Right, Doc?
Last go round.
So I just like to say it's been, again, like I started off, I'm glad that we finally have been able to get you on the show. Yeah. We thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to come on the show. And folks, listen, this is not the last time you will see Jeneen on No Notes. I mean, we're going to have her back, just like we're going to have Omar back to be announced, but we're going to have him back. Okay. But, you know, this is going to be an ongoing thing because as you have heard, it's constant development here. I mean, this is nonstop. You know, she's developing, she's growing, she's bringing up people, she's bringing up her children. You know, she could bring you up too. So I mean, and that's a continuous journey. Life is a continuous journey.
It certainly is.
So just like life doesn't stop, as long as God is enabling us to go,
yes,
we're going to be nonstop. We're going to be nonstop.
That's
so
right.
Before I go, Doc, would you like to add anything?
No, because I do, but I don't, because this can go on forever.
Right. So, but that's why we said we'll be back.
The sequel, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I want to read the book.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. To be continued, yeah, as we always say.
Because this can go on all afternoon, man. Yeah.
I know.
I mean, one question leads to another. I want to ask a question about what you're doing. Does that indirectly impact marriages?
What I'm doing with the book?
The whole concept of
sounds.
It almost indirectly sound like pushes of a marriage counselor.
Wow.
I mean, I'm saying if they're coming into a marriage like she said they went into a marriage,
right,
you gotta succeed.
That's
right.
An insightful question and observation.
Yeah.
We do the destiny statement. We have helped couples do destiny statements.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking about.
And the results are amazing. Yeah. We had a couple one time. He stopped and he looked at Omar and I and he said, I'm learning things about her that I haven't known, and we've been married for over 10 years.
Okay.
And this has happened multiple times.
That's what I wanted.
Because if you didn't have this, it's a culture, like your aunt was saying to you, who to hang around,
right,
that creates a certain culture in your life that you hang around certain
types of
people. And so if you weren't raised in that culture of doing that, or you haven't developed that as a professional or as an adult, then you may not even know your wife's mission in
life. That.
Right.
You may not know your husband's mission in life. And oh my goodness, when we start to teach you about the seven key areas of life and then help you write a vision statement in all seven key areas, this is a document. This is what we do for people. And this because Omar and I, we love theory and reading and all of that. You come into our house, you don't see a television.
Okay.
It's books, more books down the basement, books everywhere, right? But the thing is that people don't, if they're not reflecting and writing and understanding that there's things that you need to do in all these different key areas of life for themselves, then how can I know that about my spouse?
True.
But oh my goodness, when we both, when I read your mission and vision statement and my together, and now my, I pulled out something out of my office the other day, because when we did Destiny Statement Institute on ground, as well as, you know, we can go to churches and do different things like that. We were running one, and my children were with me, and I think Grace may have been, she's 9 now, she was probably about 5. And she was sitting in a class with me where I was helping other people do this, and I said, well, you may not be able to write paragraphs, but you can draw your mission and vision.
Okay.
And I looked at it the other day. I just came across it going through some things in the office. So we created a culture where my Grace and Joshua and Nate are going to be asking their friends and their future, you know, potential spouses, well, what's your mission? What's your vision?
Yeah.
And if you don't have one, well, my mom and dad are going to help you. So we can see if this is a good fit or not.
Or they'll just excuse themselves. I left the iron on.
Here's the test before we move forward.
Exactly. And so, yes, Doc, that's very insightful. Okay. Yes, it has helped marriages.
Okay. And that's excellent. How about that?
Yeah,
how about that? So we're going to close out now. As always, we absolutely thank you for your support, because we always say, without you, there is no us. There would be no. So we appreciate that. You know how to find us. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, our own website, www.thenonoteshow.com. You can email us at thenonoteshow@aol.com. Once you go to our website, we have a guest book there. Please share your feedback there. We will respond back because we know how important and valuable your perspective is. And we look at that and we use that. We follow that as well. So please come check us out. You know, share what your thoughts are. Again, don't forget, all this information that we share today will be posted, as well as the show. So please, if you have time, the two Fridays of October, November, December, all that information is available to you. You have the dates. Schedule a workshop. You know, get involved. I mean, help be excellent, right?
Be excellent, yeah.
And as always, we're going to have Doc close us out. But before I forget, I did forget our number. Let me not forget.
Exactly.
You can also call us. Call the No-Note Show. 610-626-0454. That's 610-626-0454. If you'd like to appear, we love to talk to you. I mean, you could be on our show, too. I mean, that's what we do. We go around exposing lovely people. All this talent that we don't know about, we give it exposure. We help to give it exposure. That's what we do. So, you know, if you like our opportunity to appear, give us a call on that as well. Again, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
I thank you also.
And
very enlightening.
And we will definitely be announcing when we will have on. And what we might do is have them both together. How about that?
That sounds like trouble.
I don't know.
That might be a mini series.
Really. Wow.
Because that's going to be a wealth of information then. Having Omar and Jeneen together on one show. What?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Bring my tape recorder.
We will do it.
Make it happen.
Make it happen.
That's right.
So, closes out, my friend.
In the infamous words of Don Cornelius, we want to wish you love, peace, and soul.
Until next time, thank you so much for your support. Take care.
Yeah, that would be true.